What type of strength and conditioning program are we? We're a functional movement program, correct? What's in a bigger sense?
General
physical preparedness. Yep, we're a GPP program. What's another, everyone familiar with this term, GPP? General physical preparedness. And our argument is that CrossFit's the best program at maximizing someone's GPP. And that dose, we'll say, is constantly varied functional movements executed at high intensity. Constantly varied functional movements, high intensity. Now we look at variance. This is a fun one. Let's talk about what variance is not. What is variance not? Yes, that's the literal term of variance. You're correct. It's not the same thing over and over and over. I'm looking at it on a bigger picture. Variance is not doing what a lot of people think CrossFit is. They just do whatever the fuck they want to do every day and have no plan. That's really not what we're talking about when we say variance. And that kind of plays into I heard him yesterday talk about at his gym, they use a hopper to select all their workouts. And that's cool, and that's good if you want to experiment with just that hopper concept, but there'll be some moments in there where your programming's not gonna be really effective because of the same thing, because of actually what that might cause is an actual lack of variance. And you'll see that when we analyze the program. So if you have the plan of, I just wanna do 2 or 3 weeks of hopper programming and we just wanna see what happens, yes, that's cool, go for it. But if you say my programming's really solid and good because we do the hopper all the time, that's not true, because there will be opportunities where by doing something like that, you won't have as efficient programming, and you'll see why. Variance does not mean random, exactly. What are we looking at for variance? What do we want to vary?
Load.
Load, yep. Time.
Speed of repetition.
Speed of reps, what do you mean? Talk about that.
Explosive movements versus
okay.
Movements.
OK, good. So we want to vary the duration of workouts, short workouts, long workouts, really heavy workouts, really light workouts. Really short, light workouts, really short, heavy workouts, really long, light workouts, really long, heavy workouts. There's another thing, and so what we've mentioned here really talks about intensity, because what's a low intensity, lower intensity workout look like? What was that?
Like a longer distance?
Yeah, something longer. The longer you go, no matter what, the intensity is gonna be lower than a shorter workout. Relative intensity. Short workouts, short time duration, we're talking about higher intensity, higher output workouts. Now, what have we not talked about we also want to vary here? Movement selection. So movement selection is another big thing we have to look at in variance. So we'll put moves up here. You get people that say CrossFit's interval training. Is Fran an interval workout? What's your answer?
Yes. No.
You'd say no, you'd say yes, and you're both right. Here's why. Is Fran an interval workout for someone like Chris Spieler?
No.
No, because he does that thing in one continuous motion. Is Fran an interval workout for, and I'll use me as an example, for me?
Yes.
Yes, you know why? Because I take fixed breaks in there. Now, it's not an interval workout that has fixed rest periods, but an interval workout has you do some movement, you stop, you take a rest, you do some movement. And a lot of CrossFit workouts for individuals essentially become interval workouts with random rest cycles. Those same workouts that are interval workouts with random rest cycles for someone like Chris Spieler are not interval workouts because he's able to go straight through. So that's a unique way to take a look at that contention that we were interval workouts, because it is at some stage, but eventually you get to this stage where the workouts are not intervals. And reps, play around with all that stuff. None of this is do 20, 14, 10. I don't care.
I like,
you know?
The ones coming down and the others going up.
Go down and then up. Andy Stumpf used to program Fran 21, 15, 9, 9, 15, 21. He would do that.
Film me.
I'm talking about a couple where you have one, you're doing 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, but the other one you're doing one.
Oh, yeah, where so like handstand push-ups are starting high and pull-ups are starting low, and then they're coming back. And that, again, that's the kind of cool, the art is in the programming. And then that's where really, and a lot of that stuff, a lot of the reps and the way things are laid out become preference and unique to the person programming them. I have a certain way I like to program, and it's distinctly different than the way those three like to program, and that's okay. Those, all of our programs are still gonna work really well on most people, for most people, with proper scaling. And now the interesting thing too, I want you guys to take away from this, programming, good programming, there's, I hate using the term bad programming, because a lot of people use that term now, and they say, oh, they're bad programmers, but it's kind of like, it's hard to have bad programming if you keep this variance stuff in mind. Why? Why is it really hard to have bad programming? That old phrase, the magic's in the movements. The magic's in the movements, the art is in the programming. And I've been thinking about that a lot. That phrase right there speaks volumes to why this works and it's hard to mess up the programming. Because these movements are what give us the adaptation, are what make us good. And now doing these movements in these different programming, tossing them together, different schemes, different reps, that's kind of like the creative side of it.